back to the start line then for an event dominated by the Kiwi pair of Eric Murray and Hamish Bond. Overwhelming favourites for another gold medal in the men's pair. Christ the Redeemer looking down onto the lagoon. South Africa, GB, Italy, New Zealand, Australia and France in the men's pair final. Britain and Keeling. South Africa, a nation with a proud tradition in the pair. Bronze in Athens, A finalists in Sydney and Beijing. Innes and Sinclair, Nash and Satch won the bronze 4 years ago for Britain in this class. Abagnale and Di Costanzo, gold in the four at the Worlds last year. Murray and Bond, unbeaten in just the 7 years. Overwhelming favourites. Turin and Lloyd from Australia, looking to follow in the footsteps of the gold medalists from 08 and 04. And Chardin and Mortelet, looking to channel the spirit of 2000 and the brilliant victory for France of Michel Andrieux and JC Rolland. Red hot favourites, these two, defending Olympic champions. They bring a 7-year unbeaten run into the games, Bond and Murray. The Olympic final is underway in the men's pair. It's all about Bond and Murray in truth, and can anyone get through to these rowers? Nathan Twaddle alongside me won the bronze in Beijing in this event with George Bridgewater. But this Kiwi pair really are something else, aren't they?
Yeah, that's right. We had inklings back then that these guys were pretty special. We never beat them in training when they used to split out of the world champion four. It's James Dellinger and Carl Meyer. And I think we'll see the flying start from the Italians get chewed up. They went out with a real gusto, though. Oh, plenty of flying water. And the South Africans as well. Great start from them. They started fast in all their races so far. I think we'll see Australia and New Zealand start to peg those guys back. Very efficient in how they row, and they're just a steam train, the New Zealanders. They just don't stop coming. So whether South Africans and the Italians can hold this early pace, they know what the New Zealanders can do. And I guess they've just got to have the self-belief that they can dig deep and hold on.
And here come Bonds and Murray fourth at around about the 250 mark, but coming up into third place now and hunting down the early pace setters, Britain and Keeling. Sean Keeling was in the boats in Beijing, senior debut back in 2008, spent almost his entire career racing in the pair. South Africa 1:42.04 are ahead at the 500, just ahead of the Italians Abagnale and Di Costanzo. It's tremendous actually that the Italians have got their pair into this final. Initially Niccolò Mornazzi and Vincenzo Capelli were earmarked for this boat, but they rejigged things around, trying to concentrate on the eight, and have never medaled in this class. GB falling back a bit. Innes and Sinclair. Stuart Innes in the stroke seat, Sinclair in the bow. You're watching nearest the camera there, the Kiwis.
Yeah, Eric Murray, he's a bit of a monster on the erg. He can throw down no matter what the distance. And Hamish Bond in front of him. Incredible leg power. Not the tallest guy in the team or the field, but his work ethic is well known. And here they go now, rolling through the Italians. Marco Di Conzo, he was a world champion in the four last year. And at the moment, holding on to a good silver medal. Great Britain as well, starting to push back past South Africa after that flying early start. And we haven't mentioned the Australians yet, not quite in the running at the moment. What can they pull out as we start to get close to the 1,000 metre mark?
They make it look so easy and so effortless. Bond in the stroke seat, and Murray behind him in the bow. Bond from Dunedin, who started his Olympic career back in Athens. He was fifth in the four and then seventh in Beijing before they partnered up, Bond and Murray, to really smash the rest out of the water. 3-2-9-3-1 at the midway point. And next it's Italy and GB up into third and the bronze medal position. It's the race within the race, those behind Bond and Murray.
Well, they are just relentless, these guys. See, the timing they get is incredible. Lower ratings, you know, they do swing around with the bodies a lot, but as the rating comes up, their bodies move together and they just connect so well with the boat. Coached by Noel Donaldson, who's also coaching the men's eight. Noel, Australian, big pedigree with golds, Olympic golds already under his belt as a coach. And I think he had his hands full with the personality of this crew. When asked why they went so fast, he said it was because they were so good looking. The handlebar moustache of Eric Murray.
Well, they can look like whatever they want if they go this fast. Bond and Murray still. They trailed France by 0.03 of a second at 500 in the 2012 final. They're in lane six in that Eton Dorney final, but had built up a lead of a second and a half by halfway. And at 1500, more than 5 seconds clear. That's normally the pattern with the rest fighting it out behind them. But it's Italy going really, really well. This relatively inexperienced crew and just thrown in, really, this pair boat for the Italians. But they obviously saw something in them and going well. So New Zealand, Bond and Murray have won every elite regatta going all the way back. The last one they didn't win was 2008, that Australian gold medal, gin and free. But they've won every world and the 2012 Olympics since, and 5.13.55 with Britain up into second place here. Great pace from Innes and Sinclair.
Well, shades of the London race here with the New Zealanders miles out in front. We talked about the steam train that they are. They've just kept going and going, never dropping the rating, never dropping the pressure. And I think that's part of why they've stayed so good through that 8 years. They never let the hammer off. They treat every race like a chance to test themselves. South Africa there, what a wind from them, moving through Italy and South Africa back into silver to take, get it, sorry. South Africa back into silver medal position. GB being pushed into third, and the Italians, what can they do to respond now?
It's between GB and Italy for the bronze medal. South Africa have just upped their stroke rate. Italy up to 40 as well, looking to surge on towards the line. It's going to be another gold medal and another win. That's 70-71 consecutive wins for Murray and Bond in the men's pair. But after them, it's South Africa and GB being rocked back now by the Italians. It's South Africa, and what pace from Italy here.
Yep, GB just starting to struggle, not able to lift, and the Italians, the Azzurri, as they always do, start to fly. Again, massive moves from South Africa, but no doubting the gold medalists, Olympic champions, the first gold for New Zealand at this Olympics. New Zealand, Olympic champions, two-time Olympic champions. Amazing result from them.
South Africa in two and Britain pushed out by the Italians. A brilliant bronze for Abagnale and Di Costanzo. Australia nowhere. Murray and Bond have another Olympic gold medal. They just keep cranking through. They are streets ahead of the field. Murray and Bond win again, but Britain and Keeling channeling the spirit of Cech and Di Clemente, who were bronze medalists for South Africa back in Athens. And what a performance from Giovanni Abagnale and Marco Di Costanzo. An Olympic bronze medal. Mornati and Capelli were the favoured crew in 2016. But Abagnale and Di Costanzo thrown together, and they have won an improbable medal, pushing out GB. There is no medal this time round. There is no follow-on from Nash and Satch in 2012. Innes and Sinclair pushed out of it. New Zealand, we knew they were going to win the gold, and they did.
Yeah, well, no one likes to jinx the form horse, I guess, but these guys are so good. They train so hard. To have that record over such a long period of time, can see what it means to them. Double Olympic champions, undefeated. I think if there are any question marks of whether they belonged in the sphere of the likes of Redgrave, Pinsent, Karppinen, well and truly answered that. And Eric Murray there, you saw him pointing to the silver fern on his chest, looking to inspire the rest of the New Zealand Olympic team, I think.
So we're going to see the medal ceremony for the men's pair. Bond and Murray, now two-time Olympic champions, and extending this crazy winning run. No one's been able to get near them, dating all the way back to the 2008 Olympic Games. It's the last time anyone else won a major elite regatta, the Worlds or the Olympics. Drew Jin and Duncan Free on that occasion in Beijing in the pair. Ever since, Worlds and Olympics, every race has been smashed by Bond and Murray.
And you can see from those slow-mo shots how much effort they did put in. Wasn't like they cruised, but they know how to lay down a gold medal performance. See the green stone that Eric's wearing around his neck, known as a Ponamu, New Zealand greenstone, New Zealand jade. And one of those given to each member of the New Zealand Olympic team.
Les médailles seront remises par Monsieur Barry Meister, Nouvelle-Zélande, membre du Comité international olympique, Olympien, accompagné de Monsieur Jean-Christophe Roland, France, président de la Fédération internationale des sociétés d'aviron, Olympien. Médaille d'or en 2000 en M2, médaille de bronze en 1996 en M2.
The medals will be presented by Mr. Barry Meister, New Zealand, member of the International Olympic Committee, Olympian, accompanied by Mr. Jean-Christophe Roland, France, president of the International Rowing Federation, Olympian, gold medal in 2000 in the men's pair, bronze medal in 1996 in the men's pair.
Medalhas serão entregues pelo Sr. Barry Meister, Nova Zelândia, membro do Comitê Olímpico Internacional, atleta olímpico, acompanhado pelo Sr. Jean-Christophe.
Well, this has been one of the shocks of the morning, really, the medal won by the Italians. Time now for a chat and a laugh and a bit of relaxation. Goodness me, they've earned it. So the Italians, who like to concentrate on the four and the eight. And here they are on the podium, Abagnale and Di Costanzo, which was an absolutely brilliant performance.
Marco Di Costanzo.
Di Costanzo's 24 from Naples. And Giovanni Abagnale, just 21 years of age.
The Abagnale name, it's well known in rowing circles. He's been racing in the pier for a while.
And
great result for them, the bronze.
It's all about who he was going to be paired with, wasn't it, with Di Costanzo coming in ahead of Montrone, who they pushed into the eight boat.
And what a performance from South Africa. Probably Australia and France thought they were in a shout here for this medal. But an incredible wind through the third 500. Just looked like they were fading out of picture. They flew back past.
Lawrence Britton and Sean Keeling.
Sean Keeling raced against him in the Beijing Olympics. He's put in a lot of effort to earn this medal. Great moment for him.
But the golds will go to New Zealand. Bond from Dunedin. And Murray, Eric Murray from Hastings. First came together in the four that won the Worlds in Munich back in 2007. That ended GB's domination of that event, and since moving into the pair, well, the rest is history. What can you say? Just too good. Simply too good for the rest, whoever the rest are.
That's right. So Barry Meister there presenting the medals. Gold medalist himself from the New Zealand hockey team in 76. He'll be pleased to see this medal won by Eric and Hamish, as will everyone back in New Zealand. First medal of this gold medal of this Olympics for New Zealand. And these two, I think, have secured their place in the upper echelons of this sport, of the New Zealand sporting landscape too.
New Zealand, South Africa and Italy on the podium in the men's pair, Murray and Bond, the favourites, and carrying that form through to win their second Olympic gold medal.